Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Regarding the concept of God, a grave misconception which generally prevails in the minds of many people is that any act of polytheism makes a person polytheist. So people think that if a person commits an act of polytheism, then he has become a polytheist. This is absolutely a wrong notion. A person can be a monotheist person, he's following the monotheistic tradition, and in spite of that, he can indulge in certain blatant forms of polytheism. This would mean that he is doing something which is polytheistic in nature, but until and unless he willfully and intentionally acknowledges the fact that he is regarding other people to be associates of God, then such a person cannot be regarded as a polytheist. A person, as I said earlier, can be a monotheist, and he can be a deviant monotheist. He can do something which is entirely wrong and which comes under the heading of polytheism. But until and unless he admits to polytheism, he cannot be regarded as a polytheist. We'll debate with such a person, we'll criticize him, we'll tell him that what he's doing is absolutely not in accordance with monotheism, which he is himself following, and we'll tell him that he's doing something which comes under polytheism, which is an act of polytheism. However, until and unless he willfully and intentionally knows that he is acknowledging other associates with God, we cannot call such a person a polytheist. Now, precisely for this reason, we find that not anywhere in the Quran are the Christians called as polytheists. We know that they indulge in some blatant forms of polytheism. For example, when the concept of Trinity is nothing but a manifestation of polytheism. But the Quran, in spite of this, has not called them polytheists, because they themselves think that they are doing something which is in accordance with monotheism. So we must make this distinction, that an act of polytheism does not make a person a polytheist. For example, if a Muslim, who is of course a monotheist, if he does something which is against monotheism, for example, he makes someone his mediator towards God, or he starts to go towards certain saints or certain pious people and make them and supplicate them before them and request them to request to God to grant his wishes, then of course he would be doing something which comes under polytheism. It would be an act of polytheism, but we cannot call such a person a polytheist. We will tell him that he is doing something which is an act of polytheism, but we cannot label him as a polytheist until and unless he himself knows, and he of course knows with all his intentions, that he is associating other people with God. We know that all such people, they do not associate other things with God, other people with God, or other associates with God. All they do is, all they think is that they are doing something which is primarily in accordance with monotheism. So we must make this distinction. We must not call people from whom acts of polytheism emanate, we cannot label them polytheists. They are people who are primarily monotheists, but from them emerges or emanates acts of polytheism, but the two are entirely different things. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ